Today on TidBytes, I want to show you the new features in Final Cut Pro 10.4.4. Let's take a look. Hey, how's it going? I'm Ken from the Computer Clan, and Final Cut Pro 10.4.4 is out, and best of all, it is a free upgrade for existing Final Cut Pro users, so if the upgrade hasn't come through automatically through the App Store, check your updates, it should be there for you, free update. So inside of Final Cut Pro, if you go to the Help menu and click on What's New, you'll see there are some great new features, and I will go into much more later, and I also have another thing that Apple announced that I do want to share with you, and I'll share that near the end, but for now, let's just dive into some demos. One of the new things is extensions. Now, Final Cut Pro has had plugin support for a long time. There's actually a huge ecosystem of Final Cut Pro plugins out there, but now Apple has a first-party collation solution for this. It's their own gallery of plugins. You can access them right inside of Final Cut Pro. You can get them right from the Mac App Store and summon them with this little button in your toolbar. So if you want things like Shutterstock or Frame.io accessible right inside of Final Cut Pro, you can now do that with 10.4.4. Now, I'm not sure if this is working for everybody yet. It is brand new at the time I am making this demo, because every time I click the get button, nothing happens. But if it works for you, great. There's only a few things available right now, but there's more coming. For the first new feature I want to show, I'm going to go to the window menu, go to show in workspace, and open the new comparison viewer. So let's say I want to color grade this clip. I may want to see what it looks like ungraded next to a view of what it looks like after grading. So in the comparison viewer here, I like to use the saved tab on top, and then I can click on saved frame. So let's say I want this part of this vintage Apple Vault episode that I've been shooting. I want to color correct this and grade it right here where my finger is. I'm going to save that, and now that will show up in my comparison viewer. In fact, I can save up to 30 frames and switch between them in the frame browser. So if I want a different frame of this episode, I can hit save frame, and inside the frame browser, I can simply switch between the two. So let's go back to that shot of the G4 cube and let's do some color adjustments. So shortcut command 6 to get to my color corrections, push those highlights, crush the blacks here. So now, instead of always going on and off and on and off to see my corrections, I can just look at the graded clip next to the ungraded clip right here inside of the new comparison viewer. Next, I'm gonna show the floating timecode window. So I'm gonna turn off the comparison viewer, go back to the window menu and choose source timecode. So what this will do is it will show me the project timecode on top in white, and then it will give me sources. So down here, I have an A-roll shot of me talking, and then I have a B-roll shot of this G4 cube. And as you can see, I have the A-roll shot timecode here, the B-roll shot timecode here, the project timecode on the top, and this music track on the bottom. And as I scrub, you will see all the timecodes adjust. And with this little arrow in the upper right, I can choose what information I want displayed and what information I want hidden. And I can even make the background semi-transparent if I want to. Another cool thing is I can do batch exporting of projects and clips from the browser. Shift F is the shortcut to find a timeline item inside the browser. So if I want to batch share a bunch of clips, let's say I need to round trip them with another program, I can command click the three that I want, go to File, share three clips, and I can export with any of my presets. I can also send the clips to compressor. The marquee selection in the timeline has also been updated. So let's say I have these clips in a secondary storyline. Normally, if I did a marquee selection, this would always happen. I would individually select the clips inside of the storyline. I could never actually select the entire storyline with a marquee, but now I can. If I drag the marquee around the gray part of the storyline, I can select the whole thing with the marquee selection. Let's look at the comic effect. I'm gonna go to the effects browser, type in comic. This is a new effect in here. I'm gonna drag that on. So what it will do is it'll take live action footage and give it a comic look. And there's a lot of ways I can mess with this, but my favorite way to use this is with the black and white mode. And I like to shrink the ink edges down to be really small. So now we can kind of have like a comic book look going on here. Oh, now we're looking really pop arty. So the comic effects are now new, built into Final Cut Pro 10.4.4. Let's look at video noise reduction. So I was shooting a film in an abandoned theater, and as you could imagine, it's pretty darn dark. And just for the sake of the demo, I'm really going to push the highlights up. I'm going to push them to a point probably where I shouldn't push them. Because now, if we zoom in here, this is 4K footage, but if we zoom in here, you're going to see we're going to get a lot of noise now. I can work with this low light footage and reduce the noise. I'm going to drop the noise reduction effect on here and watch what it does. You sit for a little bit and then there's the result. It smoothed out some of the noise. And I'm just going to warn you ahead of time, this process can really take a long time to render, especially on an older computer. Now, my computer at this time is 5 years old, so it's a little bit slow with this kind of stuff. Newer computers might be fine, but just be warned, noise reduction can be kind of sluggish. In the inspector here, I can adjust how much noise reduction I want applied, and I can adjust how much sharpening is added after the effect is processed. This is if I turn the effect off, you see a lot of that noise. Turn it on, it's kind of softening that noise now. I'll scrub around, find a different sample. It'll start processing again. There we go. And let's say I go to maximum, it'll reprocess. So that's maximum noise reduction, that's medium noise reduction, and that's no noise reduction. So now if I had to continue grading this and crush some of those blacks, it might not look too shabby. It's a little soft, but I can always go back and go medium and then add in a little bit of sharpness. And now it's not as bad. It's still ideal to shoot it right from the beginning, but if we look at the before and after, you can see we cranked up the light and we didn't introduce a lot of noise. Now let's take a look at another fun tech show that I do, Crazy Ken's Tech Misadventures. And coincidentally, the episode we're looking at today is about video editing, not in Final Cut Pro, but in Adobe Premiere 1.0. Wow. Times have really changed. Final Cut Pro a little while ago introduced the ability to do captions, but there's a couple differences now. So I have a caption track in here, as you can see, with all this purple on top. And one of the new features is Srt Editing and Exporting. So this is actually an Srt file that I'm working with. It's not an ITT file, it's not an SCC file, it's Srt, which is pretty standard for social media. But it doesn't just stop there. Yes, the Srt support is new, but when I go to export, here's something else I can do. Under the roles, down here is normally where I could export my caption file, but with this option here, I can actually burn the captions into the video. So with the captions burned into the video, that means all of this text right here will be permanently inside the video, burned in, pixel for pixel. It will always appear during video playback. And rest assured, if the text looks a little pixelated inside a Final Cut, don't worry, it is smoothed out and anti-aliased on export, and it looks much better. So there's some other great features built into this new version of Final Cut Pro, such as tiny planet mapping for 360 footage, and there's new 360 transitions such as a Gaussian blur and a bloom. In fact, in the description, I have a link to the release notes, and you can see all of the details that Apple outlined. As you can see, there's quite a bit to go through, so feel free to go to the description, click that link, and check that out. And this other bit is also pretty important. I did get an error message that popped up when I upgraded my libraries for this new version of Final Cut Pro. Certain formats and codecs are not going to be supported anymore in a future version of macOS, so Apple has the support document that kind of outlines it for you. I wish Final Cut Pro would actually report what content in your current projects wouldn't be compatible in the future, but apparently it does not do that. And this link here will also give you a full list of supported media formats. So that's a quick look at Final Cut Pro 10.4.4. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. And if you want to check out some of the shows that I'm editing inside of Final Cut Pro, such as Vintage Apple Vault and Crazy Ken's Tech Misadventures, please check the links in the description. Those are some pretty fun videos to watch. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you in the not too distant future.